Hi guys, Avatar here. Back again with another Papa's Cheeseria video. And once again, this is a live commentary. I'm going to be doing the second week of the game. And the only reason why I actually decided to do this was because I really enjoyed making the last one, even though it was 90 minutes. So I'm going to hopefully try to cut the time down on this game, on this video this time. So I mean, we'll see what happens. So let's just decorate the lobby here pretty darn quickly before moving on. Let's see, like I just score all the points down here I can get, just so customers don't mind waiting longer. Let's see, I have 300 in tip, so I will actually get the second fry alarm rather than the special sign. I'll get the special sign afterwards. Basically, the special sign will again make it so that more people will order the daily special. Hopefully I'll actually obtain some new ones. Now celebrating Cinco de Mayo. Maggie, oh, I like the sombrero. Chorizo sausage. Oh yeah, I actually heard that. Oh man, that looks beautiful down here. But yeah, actually, oh, the music is off. Oh, I need to get the music flowing. Oh yeah. Yeah, I actually heard that once all the ingredients in the Cinco de Mayo holiday are unlocked, you can actually make quesadillas. That's going to be interesting to make quesadillas. Let's see that barbecue sauce on top of that, and bada bim, bada boom. Let's put an alarm on there and let's already start cooking the fries. Just to make it clear, guys, I haven't been playing at all between this recording and the previous recording. This is like in one set recording, so I haven't gotten to practice at all on my live commentary aspect. So we'll see how it goes. Now, if you remember last video, I remembered this one by heart. It's wheat loaf, cheddar cheese. Oh, do this first. Let's see, then it's bacon, lettuce, tomato, and ranch. Reason? Cheesy BLT, bacon, lettuce, tomato, ranch bottle in the back, which is the ranch, basically. And the reason why the wheat and the cheddar came from, I just remembered what stood right here. That's quite easy to remember, actually, once you get the practice flowing. Let's just get this sliced in there. That's the first of the fries down. Let's cook the next set. Let's put that one down there. Can instantly cook these once I take this order. Kenji. Sounds like Kenshi. Like if you've heard Kenshi before, then you probably know which game I'm talking about, but I'm not gonna bring up the game. Not actually Mortal Kombat X. Like I haven't played it, but I have seen footage of it. I have seen footage of the game. It really is. It's a gory game, to say the least. Okay, cheese on top of here. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I will be able to serve it in time. So, almost perfect. I love the music. Well, this is like a one set order right here. Yeah, I do think the customer might mind waiting longer. Oh, wait. Yay, that's my first bronze customer award. Special price. Ah, okay, I see. Because I served five orders of the Cheesy BLT, I actually got a special reward for it, and that's interesting. It basically makes it more in order. I try to talk non-stop, but it's harder than it sounds. Let's see, sour, chicken, tomatoes, ranch. No, it's harder than it sounds. Live commentary, and I have to admit is that Yeah, I actually believed it would have been easier, but actually it's really, really difficult. Sort of style. Ugh, fucking lag. I swear, I'm sorry. I'm just so used to do it in my life-to-life basis. There's no way of beeping it out for me, so... I mean, I'm getting good orders this time out, so that's good. It's just that I don't feel like I'm talking enough. Nah, you know, I won't... normal ones in there... Like, I don't know, yeah, it's tough to explain. Anyways, I do have some stuff to talk about, and basically, it's summer vacation here. Well, not yet, technically. Because I still have to meet up on oh, god dang it, I sliced that wrong. Oh, I'm just so used to the other games where I just put it down and it goes instantly, but here we actually have to place it perfectly. Ugh, look at that. This side here is like 2 times larger than this one. Anyway, I still have to meet up on Monday on school for the last day of school. And, that was my tea there. I just grabbed a new cup of tea. Yeah, so technically it isn't vacation yet, but I'm free tomorrow. I'm free this Friday. I'm free this weekend, naturally. And, Monday I only have to turn up then, and I might take my friends out for some pizza. That's actually weird for me to go out with my friends, because that's something that I rarely do. I rarely go out with people. I tend to just be at home and mind my own business. But I've been trying to change over the past year. You know, my New Year's resolution was to get out more, be more social, and it's been working. I've been getting out of the house more, not too much, but enough for my own tastes. That's good enough, isn't it? Like, I'm not aiming towards a sandwich, I'm just aiming towards the entire social factor. Wait a minute, I have 2 sets of fries going, and I only have 1 order left. Oh, they're both oh no, that was because I took out the other one. Man, this day's been going on great. I mean, this day here. I mean, not really... like, the week here, or the day here, has actually been going quite well. I mean, I delivered my books to school today, so... I mean, that kind of says something when you deliver your school books in, that, like, signals it's vacation. It's the same way as if you get back to school and you get all your books, that signals vacation is over. So, yeah. Anyway, Bacobites, Jojo know what he likes. Oh yeah, actually I forgot to explain that. This order belongs to the food critic. So how does he like this? He finds it almost perfect. Oh yeah, I've succeeded in life. I've gotten a blue ribbon. I've served all of the closers. I am the champion. Je suis bon. That was kind of an over-exaggerated, right? Yeah, probably. Anyway, my plans for the summer... Like, actually not much. I just plan on trying to make as many YouTube videos as possible. Because next school year is like pretty darn important for me, because it's the final year in high school and I plan on getting a really good education, so I have to do a lot more homework next year. Because actually this year, how do I say this without swearing? I messed up, yeah. As plain as that, I messed up. Because I became one of the best players on... Okay, I get it. I became one of the best players on Ninikiwi? Yeah, I became one of the best players on Ninikiwi over the Fingerless gloves, nice. I became one of the best players in Nikiwi over the course of the vacation, or last vacation. And I kind of let that get into my head at the start of this school year, which now has run its course. So my grades have been a little bit lower this year than I would have liked. But I don't mind. Basically because I have next year again. But then again, that's the final year in high school, so then it matters. Like, anyway, I just got that out of the way now because this actually is really stressful. Like, I get the. Okay. Ah! Interesting. Okay, I barely got that one. Yeah, I have to say, these pipe type of games, I play these a lot. And I have some fast reaction time, so I'm good at it as well. Bam. 7 seconds out on the clock. Je suis bon. If you don't speak French, that means I am good. Yeah. No, that's actually quite a funny story. I might actually tell it. Should I, guys? Should I tell the story? Oh, the chef's hat. Oh yeah, that's right. I unlocked this. I'm gonna give it this one to him. Striped arms or fingerless gloves. Oh yeah, that definitely suits him. Do these suits? Now, you know what? These blue ones actually suit way better than the pink ones. Yeah, let's keep it like this. Okay, if you guys think I'm strange because I like care about the things my guys are wearing, it's because I am always used of having I'm used of having custom workers. The reason why I don't have custom workers this time is because I wanted to make it easy for the video. Because usually I spend like so much time trying to like make a perfect custom worker. Then again, I am playing on my mom's computer, which and normally I play on my own computer. Which again, the reason I play on this com on my mom's computer is because I don't have the ability to record my own audio on my own computer for some other reason, which I don't understand. Is there anything else I can purchase? Yeah, let's purchase the light alarm before someone starts holding the light ones and not prepared. I was like being on the safe side. I don't purchase too many furniture. I don't mind the waiting because I can get the orders out in time. But minding the orders in terms of cooking and frying? Ah, the tortilla! That's like a perfect accent right there. What? How do you pronounce that? Oaxaca? Okay, I'm sorry guys, I'm just gonna have to go to the pause menu pretty damn quickly and I'm gonna have to check out this cheese. Oh, and that's right, I earned a blue ribbon, so customers give me more tip because of this. Anyway, let's see. Cookbook. As you can actually see all the ingredients here. Ah, that's nice, you can actually see which ones are like only for a holiday. Oh, that's the cheese, that's Oaxaca? Oaxaca! Oaxaca cheese! Ah. I just went all out, I don't know what. And we unlocked the tortilla. Yeah, if any of clothing has a theme that matches the current holiday, you'll earn an extra tip for each item. Let me actually do that straight away, actually. And it's this cheese, that's the. Like, I like how they do it, how they put stringed cheese on like those food paper basket those plastic wraps. Let's do the fries first. There we go. Again, that's a T if you don't notice that. Hang on, I just want to check out is it because the tortilla must be. Yeah, the tortilla is also based on the holiday. Like, I think I've never really unlocked a holiday, two holiday toppings on the same day in a row. I never think I have had that. I've unlocked two toppings on the same day, but usually one is a standard topping and one is a holiday topping. In that case, like in the previous games I've played. Never before have I unlocked two holiday ingredients on the same day. In this case, tortilla. And let's look it up again. Oaxaca cheese. Do you want me to say that cheese like that? I can barely even pronounce cheese that way. I can barely pronounce that cheese normal. I just have to say Oaxaca cheese. Can't say Oaxaca cheese. It just doesn't sound right. Okay, that's normal fries. Again, I have really good eyesight, so I'm gonna see that here. It's just normal French fry, not a curly. No curly wurly today. Anyway, yeah, I was actually gonna talk about plans for the summer. Like, again, I said it in the last video, I get off track really easily. But the plans for the summer, I plan on doing just YouTube, to be honest. Because again, I've had lots of stuff ongoing. Oh, there's the fries. Just put on the plate instantly. Man, could you notice the lag? Okay, cheesy BLT. Like last time, I remember this order completely. It is this loaf with this cheese. BLT, bacon, lettuce, tomato. That makes it really easy to remember. And the ranch. The only thing that's really darn hard to remember is the type of bread and the type of cheese. But as soon as you... Oh my god, that was lag and I cut it like almost perfect. Okay, order 3 is curly wurdies. I just call them curly wurdies just because why not. Bacon, good choice. Love bacon. Summer plans. YouTube. Now, of course, I will actually be going away in the summer for 2 weeks. I'll basically be going to the place where I was living before moving here to a big city in Norway. Like, I live in Trondheim, pronounced in Norwegian, so if you ever come to Norway, you know how to pronounce Trondheim now. Oh, okay, he has the ability to give us a new daily special. That's what this ticket here means, or this envelope. So I'm gonna have to do my best to impress Doan. This lag is not making it easy. Like, I'm not sure if you guys can sense lag, but I definitely can. Like, I've played multiplayer so much before in SS4 that I know lag when I see it. It's the same with reloading the guns in SS4, kind of. I can sense when it drops. Again, I don't try to mix up all the other games in here, but I don't know. Well, I will be going away for a week or so to the place I lived before I moved here to Trondheim. So I will basically be seeing my friends again, my old friends. Feels like a little bit weird actually, because I've never really had like that old type friend reunion. I didn't get anything else. I didn't get an extra star or anything. Eh, must be a one-time deal thing only, I think. That sounds the most reasonable. And I'll look up this, and I'll take the order. It's probably the closer anyways. No, I actually don't think so. There should be one more customer. Yeah. So, yeah, Connor, if you could see, he was a bronze customer. The thing about the customer rankings... Yes, this one. Okay, lag. Bacon, lettuce. So that was actually off. Tomato, ranch. Oh yeah, when you remember the order completely, then you know you're good. Okay, place that on. That one's regular. Oh god. The lag is real. The struggle is real. I actually don't know where this is from, believe it or not. Okay, is he happy? Yes, he's perfect! The classic club. Okay, I'm gonna have to remember this one. Okay, so that is definitely gonna be the next daily special. And again, also something about the daily specials is that all of them give different bonuses. So basically, if you saw the BLT here, the cheesy BLT, what that one does is... Oh, come on. The cheese BLT gives you 1.5 times extra tip. So basically, that's 50% extra tip. So I curious to see what this custard club, whatever it was called. I wonder whatever that one will give you in terms of bonus. I can't remember correctly. There's one. Like, I saw a couple of the previews of the game before it came out, and I kind of remember that it was one called the Bird Buster, I think. Like, I think that Roy came in last time, or there was one customer who came in last time in the last video. Oh shit. Whew. I was actually cooked already. Okay. Yeah, I remember that there was one customer who came in the previous episode, who had that envelope, and I somehow managed to screw it up. No, it was Sasha. Yeah, it was Sasha. It was Sasha, not Roy, because Roy is the one who has the Bird Buster, from what I've heard. And the Bird Buster, the bonus that that gives you. Is that it gives you two extra Houdini tickets. So you saw the Rico chili thing that I played after ending last day. How did I manage to screw up that? Come on. What did I do wrong in the build station? Like, I don't know, Sometimes I just get bad scores for no reason. And still, like, there, I think it's at 97% service quality the other day. I always manage to just keep myself over 95%. In some way, always. Ah, Pizza Pachinko. Pachinko! Yeah. Okay. Nah. Damn it. Like, it's the tail and the anchovy right there. Like, it just makes it flip up a little bit. Hang on. Yes, there we go. Clutch. Nah, not really clutch, just like, really good planning. This is gonna be a little bit tricky. Hang on. Oh, damn it, I just missed the pepperoni slicer. Like, if you're noticing how I do the entire voice thingabobs, or, you know, basically how I change the volume of my voice, like so, I'm just really good at impressioning. Okay, let's change this one. The Classic Club, that's it. Okay, so how does the Classic Club work? Like I said, in the last video, I try to remember every single of these daily specials. So the cheesy BLT, that's pretty darn easy. It's BLT, so bacon, lettuce, tomato. You have the ranch bottle here, that says the ranch on top. So that's like the easy part, remember. The hard part is the bread. That's easy, it's just the wheat bread and the cheddar cheese. Shredded cheddar cheese. Try saying that three times fast. Shredded cheddar cheese. I can't even say it twice. Anyway, this is just easy to remember. Classic Club, however, and that could be a little bit more challenging. Now, it's white bread and goat's cheese. It's ham and turkey. So basically, it's a pig and a bird. And then another pig with the bacon and the lettuce and tomato. Oh, okay, I get it. Yeah, so it's a BLT on top of... Okay, I have a good one. It's a pig, and... No, actually, no, let's not do the pig, because I can easily misinterpret the pig for the bacon. But not in this context, actually. The pig and a turkey eat a BLT. Like, that's already three of the ingredients right there. So, the pig, turkey, BLT. Like, in that order. Ham, turkey, bacon, lettuce, tomato. And then all that's left to remember is the bread. And... You can actually see right here in the background is the goat's, it's the goat's cheese. I think it's called the goat's cheese. And then the bread is just a plain bread. So actually quite easy. It's just the it's the plain bread with the goat cheese in the picture here. And then you have a pig and a turkey who are eating a BLT. That easy. Close cookbook. And oh, I was gonna ch no. I'm just gonna change it. There we go. That's a special. Okay, so it's a regular goat's cheese, ham, turkey, bacon, then it's tomato. You can always go back and check if that was correct. However, I know that was correct. Anyway, I wasted a bunch of time talking there, so again, I'm sorry. Okay, I usually don't care too much about the first hole in terms of decorating the lobby. It's because I'm spending all my cash in the upgrades part here. So let's see, I can only afford one cook booster, so I'll just get well done alarm first. Now I'm gonna start getting all the boosters. First the cook boosters, then the fry boosters. Makes it way easier to get the orders out. But anyway, I was gonna talk about my voice changes and how well I am at them. Basically, I'm really well at interpreting. Guacamole. Naturally. When you think of Mexico. Mexico. Okay, so I'm really good at interpreting. Or basically, Well, how come I suddenly have lost the word? I don't know how. But basically, it's just something that I've worked on with the ability to say different things in different quote unquote ways. It's the way that the sauce makes when it hits the. There we go, cook that sucker faster. Let's put the fries in first. Ugh, it's too bad we can't get any more fryers. But anyway, I listened to this comedian called Kevin Bridges. He's Scottish. Scottish, I think. That might be Irish. I actually don't remember. It's been a while since I've actually seen him perform. Anyway, he. Oh my god, that looks fucking disgusting. Sorry for swearing, by the way. Oh, I can see how this becomes a quesadilla quite easily. But he used to say things like how going to the movies was difficult for him because of his really strong Scottish accent. So basically, he wanted to go see a movie, The Taking of Pelham 123. He pronounced it The Taking of Pelham 123. I actually follow something. It's gonna be quite funny for me to actually hear how I sound like when I say things like that, because I never hear myself say The Taking of Pelham 123 in that accent. Okay, the classic club. Let's break up for a while. Let's do this one. So we had a normal bread. We had a goat's cheese. We had goat cheese there as well. We had the no, nope. We had the pig, the turkey. We're eating B. No, L, T. That's possibly good. Got it in the bag. Second one remembered straight away. If you can remember, I screwed up on the first one once. But that was just like a temporary one, just because I didn't have the technique down yet. I have now though, so from now on it should be quite easy to remember them. Then again, the more daily specials there will be, the harder it will be to remember them all. So, oh, hang on, I never checked out the bonus of this. I just have to check this out. 140% points. Damn. That basically means fast rank up right there. That's OP. Anyway. That's the first order, second order, this is the third one, that's normal fries. That's why I place it on this one, so I can boost that. Let's serve the first one so we don't get complaints. We're waiting. But yeah, anyway, the Kevin Bridges factor. The taking of Pelham to free. Now, I just like saying that. I don't know why. Like, I know I got really caught up into that, and then also when he just talked about, I don't know, some... I don't quite remember what it was, like, it was drugs. Like, you know, how you shouldn't do drugs. So we then did a couple drugs, like speed. Or basically, not really, like, pronouncing it. So he had ecstasy, speed, and then the best one, horse tranquilizer. Like, you just roll the R a little bit along your tongue. Like, okay, kids, don't do drugs. I'm just making fun of the way that he pronounces the words, okay? And just saying how well I am at re-pronouncing it. In that sense, I do have some pretty darn good accents, you know? So basically, with that Scottish accent, I just have to say to myself, the taking of Pelham to free, and then I can talk Scottish all perfectly by myself. Well, kind of. I've lost the... Yeah, that one needed to flip anyways. Oh, come on. The lag is real. I wanted the classic club, actually, and didn't want to have his own. Maybe there are some customers that will always, always, always order the daily special. Okay, ham, turkey, bacon, lettuce, tomato. Tomato, tomato. It's not the same thing, but it is the same thing at the same time. But I'm also pretty darn good at other accents. I'm not just good at... at the Scottish accent. I'm also pretty good at the Italian accent. Like, I just need to get in the character a little bit. Shoot to the zombies, bop da boopy. That is like a really good technique to get into the Italian accent. Oh, you heard that? That was like perfect. That was like my perfect... God dang it, forgot to put the clock on this one. Anyway, let's just get this one out of the door before we take the next order. But yeah, you can instantly get right there how it's so easy for me to do these different voice changes, because, you know, it's all about training your vocal cords. And actually, I do sing a little bit. Like, not... I don't sing pro sauce, but I sing more or less silently to myself when I'm all alone in the house. You know, when my parents aren't home and I'm just listening to some... beastie music. So, yeah. Basically, the music type that I like is... I actually like electronic music. Like, you know, the ones that I use constantly in my videos. Or in my old videos, you know, I like trance, I like, house, I like dubstep, I like... I'm sorry, I just have to laugh a little bit every single time I hear one of those bottles just... Sounds like a fart. No one wants to eat a fart, do they? Only the most, it's been just a French Friday today, actually. It's quite good. Yeah, anyways, not all that music just electronics. It's also vocalists. And there are actually a couple of vocalists that I really like in the electronic songs. Let's see, who are they again? There were Vila, Aloma Steel, Car. The one I used in the VIP Mapmaster video, that was like 3 videos ago or something. Yeah, basically just mostly the female vocalists. I don't know why. I just do. It's the same reason why I actually wanted to have Scarlet as the main cook in this game. But I didn't end up doing that for some odd reason. Actually, that's also something I kind of want to share, is that I am kind of planning to make my own music. Like, hopefully, sometime soon, I will get the equipment so that I actually will be able to make my own music. Like, I probably won't really be using it or be posting that much music, but like every once in a while. Waxaka Wrangler. It's all in the vocal cords, guys, it's all in the vocal cords. Papa's Raceway. If you remember last time, these guys cock blocked me. Oh god, my mouse was off the screen and was lagging. Oh my god, this really doesn't work well. Oh, but I am getting the lead. Oh yeah. Can't cock block me now, huh, Hank? I think I could get a badge if you collect a specific amount of coins. Teal zigzag. Oh, there's actually... No, that's not pretty. But it might be useful. Collect all three at once. Puts me instantly in the lead, and I'm gonna maintain it. Unless I screw up like I did there. And basically what the coins do is, the more coins you collect, the faster you go. So you want to collect as many coins as possible, don't just rely on being faster than the others. Collect the coins, you will go faster. If you fail still, you will still get some cash out of it. I think each coin is like worth 10 cents. Haha, screw that. Oh god dang it. Oh no. And this is actually something that I thought of the first time I played this. What if the other people in the go-karts are other people who are playing? That's very unlikely, because this game just came out, and very unlikely that so many people are playing. Yeah, like, see, I got there. I don't know how many coins I got. Like, you guys might feel free to count how many coins I got. Like, it might not be 10 cents per coin, I think it's 20 cents per coin. I'm not sure. Oh, she no- Akari, why did you knock the cone into me? Like, yeah, that's worth noting. I actually know the names of most of these characters in these games. Just because I've been playing these so much when I was... younger, quote-unquote. Anyway, new arms is this. Oh my god, that looks fucking... Again, sorry for swearing, but this just looks so wrong on Rudy. Let's see how it looks on Scarlet. That looks way better. I still don't like the color of the stripes. Like, I know that if you go to the shop, you go to the clothing, you can actually pick the colors now. They didn't used to have that. Oh, lime green. No, this is lime green. Oh my god, I'm sold on lime green. Let's see if we can actually... not glasses, no, arms. Yeah, I say glasses, by the way. I hope you don't... Oh no, they don't have lime green. Damn it. Shit. Okay, wait. Okay, so basically it's brownish, that's like the base color. So that's teal, that's violet, that's... Oh my god. Look at these gloves, oh my... Oh, they look freaking disgusting. Oh wait, you can actually not pick colors on some of these. Just a wristband or something. And just a band-aid. Can you imagine changing the color on a band-aid? Oh my god. No. Let's see, I have $124. That's enough for a second booster. Nice. Oh, I didn't decorate the lobby. Damn it. Piggy. Jalapeno. And there's the Mexican in me, jalapeno. I don't like chilies. I actually don't mind chilies. It's just the fact that my stomach just doesn't tol doesn't I just don't tolerate. Oh, jalapenos is also cheese fried toppings. That's good to know. It's actually quite fun to see how some of these toppings for the grilled cheese also go to the fry station. That's quite interesting. Definitely not something that I would have thought of. If you guys remember, I just find it so disgusting to hear that fart sound coming from the entire time. Let's put the curly fries on. I suspect they're gonna be more fries. Okay, hang on. If you guys want to know, this is how I usually play. I just do random stuff from time to time. I just want to check if there are more types of fries to unlock. See, now there's the sauces. Yep. There are three more types of fries to unlock. Three more. Okay, I'm just looking at the badge here. I can't really make out what the other ones are supposed to be. I guess onion rings would actually be. That's like what I'm thinking. It's gonna be like French fried, springy side. Now's my tongue against the bottom of my mouth. Oh my god! I remember that Sasha came in once with a daily special, and somehow I managed to screw it up. I don't know how I did it. Oh yeah, I feel like I'm getting the hang of the game now. How are you guys enjoying this, by the way? I really hope you do. I hope you get interested by this entire game. Like again, it's a live commentary, so I try not to be as much into the game as usually when I just play. Some YouTubers they just play the game. I usually also play the game. But the thing is. That was already flipped. Whoopsie. I just thought for once, why not make it the way that some YouTubers do? That you just talk during the game. Okay, normal ones are gonna go straight in. Too bad I don't have a booster here. Okay, jalapenos. I always flip that just in case. You guys should do that too if you're gonna end up playing this game. I really enjoy this. No, it's just been a while. So, oh, build expert, nice. Build expert. Love the sombrero, Maggie. Like this is probably just a holiday only thing, because that's usually how most people work. Is that, or not how most people? I mean, but in this game, usually, let's see. This is 2, 3. Okay, so the normal fries are gonna go in anyways, and these ones are done. Jesus Christ, I'm going through this quickly. Is that the customers in this game? Is that they wear specific stuff based on the holiday. For example, I know that this one customer is called Georgito. I would say it, Georgito. He usually wears a green outfit for St. Patrick's Day. I just call it St. Patrick's Day. Why not? Oh. Second bronze customer, yes. Yeah, in case you don't know what the bronze customers do, they order their meals quicker, they give more tips, and they give more customer points. And it's always nice with customer points. This is actually gonna get sorted away. Oh, I just need two more, and then I get something else, something bonus prize. Like, I think the sign really is helping, actually. You know, the sign that I purchased in the club, in the... Not the club, see, I was looking at this. No, the sign I purchased in the store, that, it makes more customers order the daily special. Let's see, that's the ham, glazed turkey. No, that was a turkey, I mean, sorry. BLT. Like, see, I remember exactly how one makes a club, a classic club. And I'm not even looking at it. Like, you see those memory techniques there? Like, again, I'll bring back the memory techniques in a future video, because it's tough talking about those memory techniques at the same time as playing this game. It requires a lot of brain processing on my part. Still not getting the grill expert, though. Okay, so already 45 minutes into this video, and it is day 4, yeah. So this is gonna be another really, really, really long video. But I do it for you guys. You know, I love you guys. I love making videos. I just don't make enough of them. So making a special every once in a while is something that I definitely want to do. And if you guys have any ideas of a special video to do, then let me know. I kind of accept everything. Oh, this is bad. Cut. Ouch. Have I told you how much I love bacon? I have. Okay, one more classic club. It's gonna be the next day though, for sure. Yeah, so, okay, I kind of want to discuss my plans for YouTube, actually, a little bit. Because since I have the entire summer off, I definitely want to try to make as many videos as possible. But I'm trying to bring some variety to my channel. Because lately, I've just been posting SS4 videos. If you guys haven't played SS4 before, since you might just be here for the Cheeseria videos, because it's a brand new game and you want to learn more about it, which I totally understand. SS4 is a shooting game. It's a zombie-esque shooting game from Ninja Kiwi. And basically the zombie apocalypse in the future. And bacon boss. I am the bacon boss. Yeah, so it's an apocalyptic game in the future where zombies have taken over, and you have to do specific missions where you fight the zombies to try and combat the apocalypse. And you're an SES soldier, Special Air Service. Jalapeño pal. Vocal cords. Do I say that too much? Probably do. If you guys remember, this is one of my favorite ones, Mitch's Mess. It requires a lot of brain focus, so don't expect any talk for the next minute or so. Taco! Oh my god, where is that? Oh, there's a small crumb, really? And there we go. Like, Mitch's Mess has been like here since the start of when I introduced these, I think. It might have been introduced in the second game where they had for these, but I don't quite remember. Sheriff Star. Oh, come on, Marble Burger. Again, it's just so hard, this one. From time to time. Knife. Where's the last one? 5 seconds. I can't find it. There it is. Oh no. Shit, I saw it at the last second and I was... Oh, dang it. Oh, and the thing is, every time you... Whenever you fail, it changes the format up again, so... It's not guaranteed that the Sheriff Star is gonna show up again. Dang it. Okay, knife. I clicked right next to it. Spatula. Burger. Hanging chitty stuff. And a gummy onion. Where's the gum? There we go. And like, that's the thing between the different games, is that between each of the Paprika games, Mermaid's Mess is included, they sort things out in a different way, and they add more stuff. So for each game, it's like different, a different Mitch's Mess setup. So for, basically, it makes it hard. It just increases the difficulty for each game you go in between. Have you actually any clothes that match the season? Because if you have clothes that match the season, you actually get some bonus tips. So I might as well switch this. Let's see if it changed the jackets. This actually stands the best with it. Okay, lobby, planter box. I have to make sure that I don't keep too many Summer Lugo stuff in here, since that's the next holiday. That's like a really good tip. Cook with free. Basically, you know, you have the holidays and all that kind of stuff, and if you have and the furniture and the posters are marked with the holidays, and when the holiday matches the furniture theme. Southwest sauce. I wonder what's in that. Cactus, naturally. Since there's a cactus in the front. Obviously, it consists of cacti. That's, of course, how you say it in plural. Cacti. Okay. This should maybe have been like a holiday only thing, because this just reeks Cinco de Mayo for me. Anyway, tortilla. Which one is that? Oh, this might be why I screw up every once in a while. Hang on. No, I haven't unlocked him yet. Damn it. Okay, I'm gonna go with this one. Because it looks more like the part. It looks more shredded to me. Like, again, I don't have the perfect lighting in here, so if I got it wrong, then that's why. Don't yell at the freaking video. There still hasn't got any customer who has ordered a light or well done toast. The Club Classic, okay. Like, again, yeah, lettuce. Like, again, the thing about me trying to remember all of these daily specials. Like, it looks easy right now, okay? Okay, so I think I'll just talk a little bit about this. Because it looks easy trying to remember all of these daily specials by heart. Oh, look, we have two in a row, two daily specials in a row. Basically, it is actually harder than you might think. Like, right now it's easy, I'll admit that. That's only because I have two unlocked yet, which is the cheesy BLT. And yeah, I've only unlocked the cheesy BLT in the Classic Club as of now. But in the future, I will unlock more. And eventually, there are going to be, I don't remember, 40 daily specials. So that's a lot of fucking specials to keep in mind. Pardon my language. Pardon my French, more or less. Pardon mon français. Oh, none of the fries have done yet. But basically, it is harder to try and remember these things by heart, because you need to make your own system. Because if you remember how I did the last one. Oh fuck, I didn't put a timer on it. Pardon my French. Daily special, daily special, daily special. This one I'm gonna get. So it's basically this one. So it's a hot one, because it has the buffalo sauce, which naturally is hot. And jalapenos, which naturally are hot. Which again, I don't like chili. I don't like chilies. Well, I didn't put another one on there. Come on. Anyway. Where was I going with this? Wait until it was perfect. And there we go. Again, I always flip just in case. That's this one. Okay. Buffalo. Yeah, it's harder than it looks to remember everything. Because you need to have some special techniques in order to remember it. Or in order to remember the orders. Because if you remember the way I remember the cheesy BLT, it's pretty easy. It's, first of all, it's BLT, bacon, lettuce, tomato. So, you know, in that order, you put bacon first, then lettuce, then tomato. Straightforward. Then, of course, you had the ranch dressing on top of that. Long overshirt. I'm probably not going to use that, because that doesn't look too quote-unquote appetizing. But yeah, and the cheesy BLT had like a ranch bottle in the middle, in the back, so that way I kind of knew that that one had to go on top of there. Hang on a minute. This is almost the same order, except different bread, different cheese, and different and tomatoes and lettuce. Not too hard to forget. Yeah, and then the hardest part for me to actually come up with a really good way to remember is the bread cheese combo. I haven't found a really good technique of doing that yet. Then again, I've only really had two yet, as of now. So in the future, I'll probably have more too. Like make up a system. Like I said, I'll be making a more in-depth video later on when I've unlocked more extra points for the win. jalapeno. Sometimes I forget to put stuff on. But yeah, basically, the bread and cheese is the hardest to remember, as far as I know. It's just like making a really good system in terms of remembering what goes on top. Because bread and cheese is like two things, but then things you can have on top of it are like, it's five different things. Like this one, for example, jalapeno, chorizo, barbecue sauce, and tomato. So basically, it's something hot, it's something exotic from Mexico. Hang on a second. Yeah, something hot and exotic from Mexico, the chorizo, classic barbecue sauce, so that's like sauce, and then the tomatoes on top, which are just classic. Oh, there we go, hot hamwich. Hot hamwich. You know, I'm really ecstatic that I actually unlocked that. I wonder how many customers are gonna come each day, like at a maximum. But yeah, anyway, it's all about making it. It's all about making a good system in terms of remembering the orders. So that's also the reason why I remember the club sandwich quite so easy, because top layer is the same as the BLT. So, since the top layer of the sandwich club is the exact same as the cheesy BLT, hey, that's way easier to remember. But then we have the factor of the ham and turkey that's underneath it. So what I just do is that I just associate it with the animals. So ham is basically usually from a pig or a swine, and then the turkey, which is of course from a turkey. You don't have turkey from a goose. Come on, be serious. I literally just looked at the wall when I said that. So pretty much just make up your own system. I'll come back with a more in-depth video in when I've played this game more. Like, since this game is brand new and I've been playing SCS4 like crazy lately, then I'm gonna be focusing a lot on this game now. Of course, I'm not gonna be making the same type of videos as I'm making now, because we're like on the end of day 5, and we've just, hang on, 2, 1, there, an hour. This video is already an hour. If you remember the last one, it was 90 minutes. Hour and a half. So basically, these type of special videos where I just play a week are actually not too optimal, in my opinion. Just because I have to... I just have to play for like more than an hour to actually get a week in here. Sunday Shot, they used to have so many different varieties of these. Again, since I'm playing SS4 a lot, this is just so easy. You get infinite shots as well. So don't worry about missing. Well, that was easy. Now there's some where they just pop up so fast where I have to shoot them. So I think this is one of them. Buy him. Can't get away from me, bitch. See? I've just been so into SS4 lately, which is of course a shooting game, so you have to click the mouse like insane, particularly because I have semi-automatic guns. Oh yeah, I love this one. Oh yeah. Woo! Got him. Didn't sound too much exciting there, actually. I can maybe edit that. No, I'll leave it as it is. It's a live commentary anyway, so whatever mistakes I make, those mistakes I make. This looks so ugly. Got a new jacket. Oh, that's that one, yeah. Like, that just doesn't look good, in my opinion. Just put that one up there. Easter is like the holiday that was actually in the past, to be honest. In terms of, because the holidays in this game come in specific order. I can actually name them out right now. It's Cinco de Mayo, Summer Luau, Starlight Barbecue, Portolini Feast, Maple Mornings, Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, Valentine's Day, Paddy's Day, St. Paddy's Day, excuse me, and Easter. In that order. So basically, since Easter is the last one, I don't mind having Easter decorations up right now. Basically, a pro tip is that whenever you're in a specific holiday, like I'm in Cinco de Mayo right now, I kind of don't want to be using these furnitures and posters marked L, like here. Because that's for the Summer Luau, and that's the next holiday already. What they basically will do is, the day before the holiday actually starts, so basically the last day of Cinco de Mayo, I will take them down so that they will be refreshed till that day. Because again, the freshness, you know? I want to keep the freshness up top. Because currently, see here, this freshness has gone down a little bit. I only get 275 out of 310 total points. I don't mind that. No, I don't have enough tips for another booster. I was looking here and thought, oh yeah, that's enough for a new... But no, this is what I... Sadly. Anyway, let's change the special. Hot Hamwich. Let's see, this gives one ticket. So that's like a Fudini ticket. So, I just want to go through this pretty quick, just how I remember this one. Let's see, we have... It's aged Gouda. Gouda. I'm Dutch, I should be able to pronounce that. It's Gouda. On top of, let's see, what was a sour-ish? Let's see, it's... Oh, you can actually reassign these. Oh, that's nice. Let's see. It's the... Yeah, it's sourdough with aged Gouda. Sourdough aged that. Two piggies. It's lettuce. So they were having a healthy meal. And then the buffalo. Yeah. Two piggies were having a meal, or were grazing, on the territory of a buffalo. Yeah. You see, that's a really good technique to remember it. Let's see. That's sourdough, aged Gouda. Feel free to go back to check if I'm right, actually. So that's sourdough, aged Gouda. That's ham, bacon. lettuce and buffalo sauce. Like, you don't have to be smart to remember things quite easily. Julep. Oh, I'll have a mint julep, please. I actually don't know what a mint julep is. I just have heard of it. Then again, I've also heard of peppermint schnapps. Wow, that open mouth though. Okay. Again, I think it's this one. I can't see too well. Lettuce and tomato. Oh, that's so basic. How to basic right here. You order a sandwich with cheese, lettuce, and tomato. Come on, why not bacon? Make it a BLT. Okay, actually, this is a quick exclaimer, but oh, there's the hot hamage. Okay, I'll just deal with the hot hamage here first. So let's see, that's sourdough, top of aged gouda. Let's see, then we add ham, bacon, lettuce, and this. Oh, I forgot to put the fries on. Both for the same fries, so no. Anyways, let's see here. Yep, correct. As always, who's the best? I didn't hear you say anything. I'm just kidding. I mean, they don't call me Avatarinator for nothing, you know? Come on, what do you think the Nator stands for? You know? Anyway, the exclaimer here is that this game, okay, it's about making grilled cheese. It's weird for me to play this. Not two reasons, for one reason mainly. But I am lactose intolerant. So basically, I cannot eat anything in form of milk or dairy products. I can, but I will have the runs. See, that's cheese on top of that one. That's like a very random there. But yeah, I am lactose intolerant. And basically, what lactose intolerant will mean is that most forms of dairy products have what's called is lactose. I think it's a protein or something inside the milk. And the reason why someone is lactose intolerant is because you need a particular enzyme in your intestines called lactase, I think. That's like, I'm not sure how exactly it's called. But anyway, basically, you need a specific enzyme in your intestine to break down the lactose protein, so to speak. Hold on, which I really like the hair on this one. Sorry if I say this one, but I mean, I really like the hair on her. Okay, let's see. There was another one of these ones. Just eight gouda, that's it. Like, again, you see here, it's like I'm up to three daily specials right now, so it's getting tricky remembering everything. See, two piggies, grazing, and a buffalo turtle. It's that easy to remember, guys. Let's see, that's curly wurlies. Oh, wait, they're already in there. Yeah, there are already curly wurlies in there. Whoopsie. My mistake, not looking after not looking at the stuff good enough. Okay, this is the third bronze customer? Oh, the fifth one already. Wow, that's actually a lot. But yeah, basically, I'm lactose intolerant, so I cannot eat most dairy products. So that includes cheese. And it also includes milk. Yeah, you know, because I'm playing right now, it's hard to think and do things at the same time. So, yeah, I cannot have milk, I cannot have yogurt, ice cream. I always forget to put this on for a strange reason. Yeah, ice cream I cannot stand. And yogurt. And anything that actually contains that, like pancakes, waffles, stuff like that. Like again, it's kind of difficult to come up on this like straight away, but yeah, lots of lettuce. Yeah. Anyway, there are of course alternatives for me, because I, you know, there's goat's cheese, which is fine to eat. There is basically they have lactose-free types of the things I'm allergic against. You know, you have lactose-free cheese, milk, ice cream, yogurt. So, I mean, I'm not bad off. It's just the fact that I've come more along the evolutionary scale than most people. Nah, that's just kidding. But really, actually, the interesting thing is that humans aren't actually made to drink milk. Like, the only really reason why we drink milk is because it contains all the nutritions or whatever, the essential things when we are infants. So, pretty much, when we drink the breast milk of our mothers, I feel so bad saying that. But yeah, basically when we drink breast milk, it's basically to become stronger. And we keep that going by drinking milk on a regular basis. But basically, we're only really made to drink mother's milk. We're not built to drink other types of milk. So technically, we all have the ability to become lactose intolerant. It's just the fact that some people are like lucky enough, most people are lucky enough not to be that. I, sadly, am one of those unlucky ones. Then again, it's not just only lactose I'm allergic to, I'm also allergic to gluten. So if you know anything about gluten allergy, it's like the celiacs. Like again, oh, that's a perfect order. I haven't had the perfect one in a while. And on the closer on that, yes! Anyway, yeah, I'm allergic to gluten. That's some difference than being a celiac. I think that's the way you pronounce it. Feel free to correct me. Basically, the normal flour types like wheat and oats and other stuff like that kind of contains gluten. And gluten is also a type of protein. And whenever I get that, like instead of lactose, with lactose I get the runs. But with gluten, I get constipated, I get rashes, I get really nauseated. So, gluten is just way worse for me compared to lactose. That's also a thing. My mother is actually also allergic to these two things. It's just the fact that I can stand... I stand lactose better than she does, but she stands gluten better than me. Does that make sense? So basically, I can like take small traces of lactose easier than my mother can, but my mother can take small spores of gluten easier than I can. So basically I can easily get a rash by just like a couple of drizzles of flour. Okay. I wasn't really paying attention, but Chester is either here or here. I'm guessing here. I am good. Single poster. Wow. That poster actually came like almost at the end of the holiday. That's how late that one came. Okay, Roy, I have to pay attention. Like, see there? Another person just came in. And their eyes are just crossing the entire time. At least, what? Yeah, I lost track of them. You see, I said this in the last video. When their eyes cross, it's really hard to keep track on where someone goes. Particularly when multiple people cross eyes multiple times. Just follow the mouse. Okay. That one was way easier compared to the last one. Basic gloves. Should have plastic gloves, actually. My ears are starting to hurt from this headset. Ah, thank God there's only one more day left. I really can't stand this anymore. I mean, I like the idea of a live commentary, I have to say. But it's a lot harder than you think. Because not only do I have to pay attention to what's happening on the screen, I also have to try and talk constantly. You know, basically try to keep you guys interested. Not just in the game, but also just in general. You know, since I try and tell stories, I try and tell stuff about the game. So I try to make this a little bit varied. Like, you know what I mean. Wait, what did that say? Trim knit hat? Oh, you cannot find out how something is called afterwards. It was called something strange, though. Those gloves look freaking disgusting. Okay, banana gum. I know it's some Lua almost, I'll just take it out soon. Let's see. 676. Oh, better than 666. No, I'll actually take out all Summer Lua stuff as of now. Just so I actually have those guys filled up with. Like, you see the freshness on these guys, I'm just going way down. Let's see the wallpaper, flooring. Okay, good. Like, once again, this is my mother's computer I'm playing on, so this progress here is saved on the computer, it's not on an account, like on when I play on Ninikiwi. So on Ninikiwi I can play on multiple computers. Here it's based on the computer itself, rather than an account. Pajita peppers! Naturally that had to come. Basically it's just like, it's bell peppers. Paprika! So basically, since this is on my mom's computer I'm playing on, I won't have the same progress on my own computer. And it's my own computer I'm gonna be using for the most part. Basically, the plan is that there's actually not too much. There's like very little compared to what I imagined this with Vegeta Veg. The plan is that I wasn't really planning on doing two of these specials in a row. Mainly because the first one lasted an hour and a half, and I thought I could get this one under an hour, but I didn't. So this one is almost the same length as the last one. So what I'm gonna be doing is that I'm gonna be playing a lot now on my normal computer. So that I will get to the same place where I am right now, so day 14. And I will start recording each of the days. So, at day 15, I will make the next video. You know, of this game, naturally, so. Just this video and my previous, or just two specials, just to get back into the game of doing commentaries and doing videos. Okay, so time for another hot hamwich. Let's see, was this, yeah. I still remember it, I still remember it. Some are way easier to remember than others. Let's see, ham, bacon, lettuce, okay. I'm surprised the jalapeno didn't make it. Since it's a hot hamwich, I really think the jalapeno should have been on there. And apparently it isn't. I should have had a booster here. Like, again, I lost a crap ton of cash and XP parts in terms of the beginning of the game because, you know, I was... Again, it's my first time doing a live commentary. Well, second time, this one. Oh, God, I placed that wrong again. I'm just used to placing stuff here and it goes instantly there. Here, you have to place it correctly. I'm just not used to that yet. Like, you know, it's those kind of things. It's those little mistakes that I make that just... It just causes me a little bit of those customer points, which causes me to lose a little bit at less ranks. Oh, you can actually click to stop it. Oh, that's nice. Didn't have that in the... I don't know, actually. Ah. We're approaching 90 minutes, guys. Not really, we're just past 80 minutes. I just can't believe how long time it has taken me to make this plus the previous video. 3 hours. 3 hours for two videos. Usually I can like get like two videos done in an hour. Because these videos are more or less special, it just takes longer. Yeah, you know, I cut that wrongly. Placed the jalapenos wrong on the french fries. Need some work on the fry station for sure. Yeah, I'll get to you. I almost forgot I was doing a commentary for a second. Yeah, anyway, because this is my... Hang on. No, okay, that's good. Yeah, because this is my mother's computer I'm playing on and not my own, the progress here won't go over to my computer. So I'm gonna have to work through these first 2 weeks again. But that shouldn't be too much of a problem. I hope you guys won't mind it. That's normal. Actually, let's see, it's tomato and bacon. So I'm gonna have to work my way through the first 2 weeks again on my normal computer. And then I'll be starting to make daily videos. So basically, the next video is gonna be day 15. The video after that is going to be day 16, and 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and so forth, and so forth. Hang on, lettuce. There, yeah. Oh man, this video is gonna take a long time to render. I'm actually still running the previous one, to be honest. That's what, kind of why I was lagging in the beginning. And again, I use Camtasia, so shouldn't lag too long. There should be curly roties. Shit, I forgot them on there. And on bacon, that's guacamole next. 1, 2, 3. Like, this one just suits it the best because there's a big ass opening. So that one just suits the fart noise the best. Yeah. So that's pretty much it. That's, we're coming close to the end, guys. Just one more to go. We have Fudini's minigame. Which is, if I remember correct, Freezer Ball. And that's pretty much it of this video. How long these fries come? Okay, good. Anyways, I've really enjoyed making these two live commentaries right here. It cost me 3 hours of my entire evening. So... Like, I could have been playing like my remaining three Nightmare games on my Assault character on SS4. But since this game just came out, and I used to play this a lot when I was little, or in the past, I felt just like making a video. And also, keep in mind, is that I want to bring variety on my channel, so... You know, if you guys want me to play the previous two games of this series, the Pastaria and the Donateria, those ones I have not played. I've played the Cupcakeria, all the way down to the Freezeria, and that's it. But if you guys want me to play those, just say so, and I'll make them. Because, you know, I want to bring variety to my channel. I don't just want to keep uploading SS4 after SS4 after SS4 after BMC after SS4. Purple banana, that's nice. Nice. That's gonna suit well on Scarlet. Oh yeah, that's also another disclaimer real quick. Because I'll be making it on my other computer, I will be making custom markers. Oh yeah, I remember this one. Damn, too low. It's been a while since I played the Blender Ball, but I still remember it. Oh, now it's like the perfect line. Damn it! Oh. Just when you get one thing good, you get the other thing wrong. I actually think like the bottom should be like 25 cents. Okay, that's good enough. Oh, that was right next to it. Anyways, that's pretty much sums up this video. So, if you guys want me to play the other games of Papa of the Game Areas, Papa's Game Areas, let me know. I might make him anyways. But mainly, it's this game I'm gonna work on the most at the moment. I'm gonna try and get some more SS4 videos out of the way, because that's just something I want to bring up. Nightmare. I have been trying to record Nightmare games, but it's either one of two things to happen. First, I lag so much that I just keep dying, and then I usually end up like refreshing because I don't like saving those deaths, because it's like embarrassing that I lag so much that I die, because Nightmare lags like twice as much as normal gameplay. Or the second thing happens, I lag so much I actually crash my shock player. So basically, whenever I try to record a Nightmare game, I'm like wasting a ticket. Hopefully I get a new computer soon, so I might get to record Nightmare eventually. But not as of now. That's just a heads up. Basically, you know, my guy is my main guy is an assault. He's a speed damage build character, so the lag makes me unmovable, both in terms of shooting as well as moving. So I just keep him dying. Anyways, that's all I'm gonna have for you guys today. So make sure to like the video, comment, subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out, homies.